beautiful people, welcome back. I hope everyone is having a beautiful day today, and I hope that you are ready, because in today's video, first of all, I'm gonna get this first part just summed up real quick, and then we are gonna get into the video, because it is going to be a long one. Like, grab a snack, grab some popcorn, some cake, some cookies, some coffee, some Diet Coke with light ice. Just make sure that you're all kind of hooked up for something going into this, because this video is going to be, okay, this is one of the biggest projects I have ever undertaken, as far as, like, a video to try and film. And as of right now, I've been filming this video for about 4 hours, and it's gonna be probably 5 by the time I'm done with it. So let's just go ahead and get into it, okay? So here's what happened, a little bit of backstory. I had these 3 palettes come in this past week. I've been talking about them on Instagram. We have the Juvia's Place Wahala 2, the Natasha Denona new Triochrome palette, and the Huda Beauty Naughty palette. And when all of these came in, you know, individually, I had so many requests come through from you on wanting to see looks, talk about them, consistency, texture, are they worth it, are they not, so on and so forth. And I got to thinking about it going into this week, like, to set up my filming for the weekend. I was trying to figure out, you know, what's a good way that I can show them all to you, that I can showcase them, give you kind of a brief run through on all 3 of these palettes, and give you, you know, a couple of eye looks, and really just get into it in the best way possible, but still be efficient. All of that really just kind of spiraled somehow into this video, which you are watching, and obviously it's something I've never done before, so I don't know how it's gonna go over. I don't know if you like it. I know at this point I'm tired, but I think once everything is compiled together, I do think it's gonna be worth it. So I would like to introduce you to today's video. We have 3 palettes, 6 eye looks, wow, and 1 review, which of course is all encompassed in today's video. And of course, before we get going into the video, just really quickly, I do wanna pause and introduce myself for anybody that might be new here. My name is Paige. This is Seeking Alexandria. Welcome to the channel. I do put up 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and they go up right around 7:30-ish a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. And then also, if you happen to be new here and you haven't heard me screaming it from every corner of the internet, I would also really, really appreciate it if you would go follow me over on Instagram. Everything will be linked down below, but I am trying to hit 10,000 followers over there so I can get the swipe up feature. And I've also been really working on a ton of new content. I do IGTVs, makeup application, mini makeup reviews, plus size fashion, random photography stuff, portrait shots, just all kinds of fun stuff in the feed. And then also in the Insta stories, the part that you just kind of update on the day to day, I hang out with you guys and I talk about everything, whether I'm unboxing in my office, doing, you know, going for a walk, unboxing or talking about new brands, new releases, new things. I don't know, that for me is where I share my day to day life. I talk a lot about, like, work stuff, and just, I don't know, it's just where I live my life. So definitely check me out if you like, you know, this type of situation, you like me, you want more of the behind the scenes, that is where to go. But with that beautiful little summary, let's go ahead and zoom the camera way in and let's go back to all the eye looks. All right, you guys, so obviously I decided to do something a little different today. Hello, as we've already covered in the intro, which I have yet to tape. So hopefully when editing Paige gets all of this, you know, sorted, hopefully it all works out well. Who knows at this point? But obviously the point of today's video is just to sit here, play around with these 3 new eyeshadow palettes and kind of get a feel for them. We're gonna swatch them, apply them, do some eye looks. And really it's kind of like a 3-way first impression where we're just gonna sit down and, you know, test them out, test the quality, the texture. And, you know, obviously for none of these palettes can I use the entire palette or every single shade, but I just thought this would be a cool way to do, like, a wrap up. I've seen a ton of interest on all 3 of these palettes from you guys. And instead of waiting and trying to do, you know, one at a time and whatever, I figured you guys would just probably prefer this, you know, a time where we can sit down, we can hang out and just, you know, hang out, talk through some eye looks. I don't think there's much more of an explanation than that. So let's go ahead. There are a couple of things that are going to be kind of odd going into this video. For example, because I'm going to be wiping off obviously so many different eye looks, I want to be very mindful of a couple of things. So first thing I think I might do is, like, lightly sketch out a brow, because I'm the type of person, I don't know if I'm the only one, okay, but I cannot do any sort of eyeshadow look without eyebrows. Like, it doesn't work, because I naturally have 7 hairs. So I need to sculpt something, you know, of that sort. And then I think as far as palettes go, we're gonna get into, which one do I want to do first? I actually, you know what, I think I want to start with the colorful one first, and you know, just really come in hot with the new Juvia's Place. This is the Wahala 2 palette. So I'm gonna go ahead, do some sort of brow situation. Like I said, I'm not putting on any base makeup till the very end just because I want to be able to freely wipe off my big old face. So I'm going to get a little bit of brow, some swatches going, and we're going to get into some eye looks. Okay, okay. All right, you guys. So I was off of camera and I threw on a little brow. They're not perfect. I'm going to, you know, lightly conceal them. I'm not going to add brow gel. They're just there for, they're just there for guidance at this point. But before we get into the eyes and all of that, I do want to talk about this palette because I obviously went through, I swatched everything. I have swatches up and down both arms. And I have to say right off the start, the freaking color story on this, I just think it is so beautiful. Anyway, something that I thought was interesting on the Ulta website that I hadn't noticed before is that they actually break this palette down into rows. So you have row one all the way through row six over here, and they break them down, which I don't know how I didn't notice this, but if you look at them, they actually do have very beautiful color stories. Whoops, very beautiful color stories in those given rows. And so row one, which is obviously the one farthest over there, that is the ice cold row. Row two is the periwinkle row. Row three is the cobalt blue family. Four is the aquamarine family, which is gorgeous. Row five is the orange color family. And row six is the pink shimmer and shine row. And I don't know, I just thought that that was super cool, like to look at it in a little bit of a different way, because I think especially if, you know, you don't play with a lot of color, maybe you're not, you know, just like super into that, it can be a little bit overwhelming to just like see all the colors. But really when you break them down into the little individual family, like rows like that, I actually thought it was really cool, very helpful. Oh, you guys, I'm such an idiot. When I did these swatches, I did them in the wrong direction. Look at, they just trail off my arm. Okay, so how am I gonna do this? Let's just, let's maybe do something. Can you tell how long it's been since I've done swatches on my arm? Oh my word, Paige, get it together. Okay, so these are the swatch. Where's the camera? Hello, have I ever used a camera? It's my day one. Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Hey guys, so I'll be back. I just have to redo these real quick because nobody can see anything on this here camera. So I'll be right back. All right guys, so I'm back. I have the swatches ready to rock, and we do have the majority of them here, a couple on the overflow on the back of my hand. But let's just admire all of these beautiful, sexy, oh, like look at like this group right here too. It's so freaking stunning. Oh, I just love it. I love that they're so bright and so vibrant, and like the shimmers are just so just full of luster and life and happiness. I love everything about it. So now let's also show, of course, this side, which does have more shimmery goodness, glitters, and then of course one more duochrome right here. So freaking beautiful. We've done this, and I've spent literally what 30-40 minutes on just trying to get this situated. Now I'm gonna wipe it all off. Super fun. And we're actually gonna get into an eye look, play around with them, and go from there. All right, you guys, so I am back. Obviously, I just added a little concealer, which for that, I have my Benefit Boing Cakeless Concealer right here. Just, you know, a little bit of a prime situation. And I think for this video, since how I'm just going to be wiping it off anyways, and I'm not going to be doing like mascara on a full face, I thought maybe, you know, we would do like one look on each eye. That way we could play around with like double the colors, double the textures, kind of thing. All right, so I think the first place to start here is to kind of, you know, pick around and figure out what I want to do in terms of the duochromes, because for me, this is kind of like just freaking amazing. And so I think, let's see here, let's start off a little bit more chill and go in first with the shade Lit. Okay, that's the shade right here. It's nice calm little guy. And we're gonna start by taking that on, again, the Fenty 210 blending brush. And my mirror's sitting right in front of me. Okay. We're gonna start by just taking that like right in this region. Just again, a nice little light area so we can start kind of setting the crease down. Oh, that's a beautiful color. It's kind of like a nice little light popsicle kind of color. Because part of my option with this, I actually took that all the way through the crease. I quite like it. Just, you know, FYI. But part of my goal with this is I would like to be able to take this palette and do like maybe one look that's a little bit more, you know, not quite as dark and like over the top, and then do the other eye, and it can obviously go in any direction. But I'd like to more so point out the versatility of it, just, you know, for people that maybe they like one aesthetic, they don't like the other. I'd like to kind of showcase both. You know what? I think given everything I just said for this eye, I think we might actually stick more in like the bronzy kind of tones for this side. You know, more so like my neutral kind of look that I would typically go for. And to do that, I think I'm going to go in with a little bit of the shade ASAP. It's like a nice deep brown shade. I'm obviously still in the matte because I'm going to work it through the outer V. Actually, you know what? We might do this one on the inner and the outer, just to kind of give it a little bit of depth. And oh, wow, that's a beautiful shade. Yep, okay. We're gonna work this one, yeah, definitely inner and outer. And then that way in the center, we can still have something that'll give us a little pizzazz, but it doesn't have to be like too far over the top. Wow, that shade is kind of freaking beautiful. Okay, cool, love that. Okay, so I just went ahead here and I tapped on a little bit of the NYX Glitter Glue right in the center. And I'm gonna take two shades out of this palette and layer them together. I'm gonna grab first the shade Period, and then the other shade is 419, which is more of like a beautiful orangey glitter kind of situation. And I'm gonna lay down first the shimmery one right here. And then very lightly, oh, there's like a chunk of blue glitter right in the center. Sorry, there's just glitter getting all over the place, but I'm gonna lay that one down first. And then over top of that, I'm going to tap on the glitter just to give me like that nice little bright moment. And then I'll go through with my finger here and lightly blend that edge, because I really wanna layer in those two, like the glitter with the shimmer. And then also I'm gonna grab a little bit more of the shade ASAP, that dark brown shade that I worked into the inner and the outer V. I'm just very lightly going to kind of press and swiggle that over those edges right there, just to, again, very, very lightly keep everything blended. Also, just in the center, just to add on, you know, a couple little finishing moments here, I'm gonna take a little bit of the shade Fame, which is a really nice bright shade, and we're gonna pop that very, very gently just right in the center here, just to, again, lighten up that area, kind of keep it a little bit more buoyant. All right, now really quick, I am gonna just clean up this little area here. Now to do the lower lash line, I'm actually gonna take those same three shades. We have Lit, Period, and ASAP. And I'm gonna take those same ones and just work them onto the lower lash line in the same way that I already worked the them onto the upper. But I'm gonna take and just get that nice and worked on. Blend it out a little bit with the lighter shade Lit. That was the very first crease color that I used. Just as a very nice little light blend, adding on as my last little step here just a freckle of that warm shimmer shade, just to kind of help give me a little bit more warmth on the lower lash line. And then finally, I think the last step here would be a little brow bone inner eye highlight. And for that, I could actually use the shade Chakra, which is right here. Just a little itty bitty bit, make sure I get it nice and blended down. Ooh, that's pretty. And then pop a little bit here with my finger onto the inner eye. Oh, wow, okay, she's bright, she's bright. Okay, kids, she is bright, calm down. Might want to blend that one out. All right, so this is obviously how, you know, the first eye turned out, our more neutral option. And now we're gonna get in and attack this eye with a little bit more fun, a little more pizzazz, and definitely with one of them duochromes, because I'm just like drooling, dripping, needing them. So let's go ahead and start off first which one do I wanna use? I think I'm gonna go in with the shade Fake, because that's the one that I just keep being drawn back to. And so for my crease color, I'm gonna start by working in the shade Yab right here, and I'm actually going to grab a little bit of the shade Too Much as well, because they're both in that little pink family. And so I'm going to start off with the lighter, which is Yab, and I'm going to take that on my little fluffy ColourPop brush. It doesn't say which one it is, it's just a fluffy eye brush. And I'm going to start by taking that lighter pink shade more so through the crease right here. God, I can't believe how beautiful this eye is. Like, I just keep looking at it and I'm so impressed with how freaking gorgeous all those colors, they just like blended together. Oh, it's so good. Anyways, let's focus, Paige. Let's grab this shade here. And I think I'm gonna actually grab the shade Too Much right about now, which is a very hot pink. Wow, that shows up hot pink. And we're gonna take and pop that one kind of at the end toward the outer here, and then also work it into the high outer V just for that like bright, super bright moment. Oh, wow. All right, so I'm gonna go in a little bit early this time with the glitter glue, and I'm gonna pop it this time all over this entire mobile lid, because obviously, girl, y'all know I want two totally different looks, and if I'm gonna really go for that gusto, I'm gonna pick it up and I'm gonna run with it. So let's cover this whole mobile lid area right here in some glitter glue, and then go in with the shade Fake, which again, that is the super like a buttery freaking smooth duochrome. Oh my, I am so impressed with this texture. And we are just gonna take and we're gonna pop that all over the lid. Oh God, look at that. Just look at her live her best life. Like, I'm sorry, who are you? Who invited you to this party? Oh, I did, that's right, because I have great taste. Over top of that, because I was kind of debating, you know, if I wanted to really double these up and go for it, and I really feel like we need to go there. So I'm going to take the shade Money, which is the other duochrome. Oh my God, this one is so sad. They're both so beautiful. But we're going to take this shade, again, the shade Marnie, and we are going to pop that all over this little mobile lid situation right here. Actually, you know what? Maybe we'll just keep it in the center. Yeah, we're just gonna keep it in the center. Quick, I'm just cleaning up the outer V, and I want you guys to know, all over my face, you can see nothing but glitter. And that is because when I swatched this, I just got glitter all over everything. Like me, my pants, the whole situation. So if you happen to notice excessive amounts of glitter on my face, it's literally everywhere. Like there's just so much glitter in here. So just keep that in mind. It's not like a fallout situation, especially right now. It's just everywhere. But just because we're really gonna commit, we're gonna go there, let's take a little bit of this. This is the Goals Glitter, and it's the, you know, the loose kind of press glitter. And this one has a really nice combination of like true green and aquamarine blue green little particles in it. And I wanna take some of this and just kind of pop it. I'm not using any additional glitter glue. I'm just gonna like lightly kind of veil that right in the center. Because I don't know when to stop. Actually, you know what? Me, I don't know when to stop. And I'm going to put it everywhere, okay? I'm just going to lightly pop it just as a couple little extra particle funds. What did I just say? All over the lid right here. And just kind of really... Oh my God almighty, hello up above. That is so beautiful. To go in and finish up this eye, I'm actually gonna grab a little bit of the shade Dream, which is a matte kind of periwinkle shade up here. Wow, can you guys see how rich that is? Like up against my pasty ass white face. Oh my gosh, that is freaking beautiful. Okay, we're gonna add a little bit of that. And again, that is the shade Dream. I don't know if I said it. And I'm gonna pop that just a freckle bit here on the inner and outer corner. Just to add a little bit more fun and color, because I can't help myself. I think to go in on the lower portion right here, on the lower lash line, I'm gonna take the shade Jealous, which is obviously a beautiful bright-ass teal shade. And we're just gonna grab that and pop it on the lower lash line, maybe deepen it up a little bit. But I feel like we could pull like a little bit more of that color from the top part down. Kind of just going back and forth, I think, at this point in the palette between the periwinkle and the teal portions, just to kind of play around and like mix those two stories together. And then I'm gonna go in now, just as a last step here to kind of finish it off, this eye right here. I'm gonna take the Scott Barnes 59. It's like a nice little flat liner type brush. And I'm gonna take the shade Egg Bommy, I'm sorry. And I'm gonna take this shade, which is kind of like a deep, dark, tealy blue, and I'm gonna use it to just ever so gently get right down into the lower lash line. All right, you guys, so obviously I did go ahead, I added a little brow bone, a little inner eye, and this is how the eye turned out. And I think what I'm gonna do for like you guys getting to see them visually, because I know it always helps me, I'm gonna go ahead and cover one eye, give you like a nice little rounded shot of each. So just, you know, just in case it matters to you, some people it doesn't, but I'm much more of like a visual kind of person. And if you showed me this, I'd be like, what the hell? So let's go ahead here, let's get a shot of each. Obviously this is the more neutral eye, which I have to say, I'm actually really impressed with this one. Like the way that the like the vibrancy of that orange glitter really came across on camera, I think it's freaking beautiful. And then of course, let's go ahead and switch over and do this eye. This is the more intense, fun, poppy, blue, purple, green, all the shift type situation. Lomas Juvie's Place, both eye looks, super fun, a lot of versatility. And now we can go ahead and get into the next one, which means I gotta wipe it off. I gotta wipe off all my work. Ugh, that's gonna be the most depressing. Wiping off the swatches and wiping off the eye looks, like, come on. I'm gonna wipe it off everything. Okay, let's do it, Paige. Come on. This ain't the time for being upset. This is the time for wiping your damn eyeballs and continuing on with your life. Okay, let's go. All right, you guys, so I did go ahead. Obviously, I got the eyes good and cleaned off. And next up, I decided we're gonna get into the Naughty palette from Lomas Huda Beauty. And this palette I actually picked up as a set, which came with the palette, the bag, and the brushes. And I decided to pick up the set because I actually haven't used, I don't think, any of her eye brushes. At least not that I can remember in recent history. And I really liked the profile of these. I thought they were super beautiful, and they're just the kind of ones that I would reach for like in my day to day. So I figured we would go ahead and test those out. But of course, mainly we are here for the palette, and I'm currently trying, I don't apparently have any signal right now, but I am trying to pull up the palette so we can have some information on it as far as pricing and whatnot. But while that loads, let's go ahead here and look at the palette before I mess with anything. So here is the front of it. It just says Naute. And then on the inside, of course, these are the shades. And I definitely know going into this one, as far as what everyone has said, this one right here, this appears to be the little slightly measly infected shade. And this is the shade Slippery, which this one, I believe she introduced. Ooh, it loaded. My God, what good timing. This one, I believe, was introduced as some sort of like a glossy shade, wasn't it? Hold on. Slippery is a bronze and berry shimmer gloss hybrid. Interesting. But I really wanted you guys to see all of the textures and all the prettiness of it before I destroy it, because bitch, I'm about to destroy it real good. So let's get, that sounded real bad, but I'm gonna get in here with my nice little fingers and just mess it all up. Actually, you know what? While we're on camera, we're just living our best here. I think that we should mess up the shade Slippery together. Oh, it feels like a gloss. Oh, that's so weird. Okay, let's go ahead and just get it swirly. Because I read, yeah, that right there, if you can kind of see how there's like a purple smear, I read online that the little capsules, like those little measly bumpy looking things, I read online that those actually burst and release color. Very interesting. This right here is the color, which I gotta say, it's actually not that shabby. My biggest concern with this, I think, would be like, how is it gonna sit on the eye? I feel like it's gonna like repel the makeup. Let's do like a swatch of that one by itself. The hell, where's my color? Don't know how I feel about that. not exactly in love at the moment, but let's go ahead. I'm gonna swatch it really quick. We're gonna get that done, and then we're gonna get into a real quick eye look times two. Okay, let's get moving. All right, guys, so here are the swatches for the entire palette, and I have to say, I'm actually, I really, really love like the aesthetic look of this, the vibe, the colors. This is very much so in my wheelhouse. Like, this right here is an everyday kind of moment for me, and I think going through it and swatching it, the thing that jumped out at me, like the from first glance and first touch of it, is actually how buttery smooth a lot of these textures are. All right, so I think first up on this eye, I'm gonna do the brown nude section, and then I'll save the pinky side for over here. And I think, wait, is the shade Passion, is that like a duochrome? Oh my God, the shade Passion, I think, is a duochrome. How did I not? I didn't notice that until right now. Oh my God, you guys, I am such a twit. I think, oh my God, and it's like a purple light blue duochrome. I just like looked down and had like this whole moment. That is beautiful. Is that, hold on, I gotta go on the website. Is that really what that is? Like, does it say that the shade Passion is one? It is a iris and pink marble shimmer cream. Okay, so it doesn't specifically say duochrome, but I'm telling you what, I'm looking in this pan right here, and it's like, look at that. It has like a blue to pink shift. Can you see that? That's so beautiful. Oh my gosh, okay, so sorry, just had a whole moment. But I think, yeah, I'm gonna start in first, and I'm gonna take the brush here. This is the Naughty Sweeper. I'm gonna take the Naughty Sweeper. I'm gonna swipe or no swiping, okay, all over my eyelids, wow. After I throw it on the floor. Let's grab the brush, let's try this again, okay? And we're gonna sweep this little beauty here into the shade Hypnotic, which is a nice light brown color right there. Ooh, good pickup on the brush. Actually, God, these brushes look so nice. I love the profile of this. That color laid down perfectly. And as I said, for this first look, it's gonna be more of like a nice neutral brown kind of look. I'm not gonna make it overly sultry. I'm trying to do these looks like a little bit more balanced for people that you like depth, you don't like depth, you like neutral, you like that fun, you know, depthy kind of look. I'm trying to do a little bit of something for everybody. And then from there, let's grab the shade Arouse, which does have a little bit more of like a caramely warmth to it. I'm gonna take that on the same brush and just keep going in that same direction. Yeah, this brush is like rapidly becoming one of my favorite shapes. Ooh, I like this a lot. And I'm keeping it a little bit more worked up, like right up into this bone right here. That way I can lightly diffuse it toward the brow bone in the front, just to kind of help keep my eye nice and lifted. Ooh, oh, that color, oh. Love this color. I think just for like a touch on the outer V, I'm gonna take the shade Spicy, which is this one right here, and I'm just gonna go just a little itty bitty bit on the tip of this brush and just ever so nicely blend it in. And I mainly wanna concentrate this shade like right into this pocket right here, just, you know, again, to keep that lift going. Y'all know I got these little hooded ass teeny little beak eyelids. And so I really gotta create that dimension where I can. This shade Flower Power, I just think it is so freaking gorgeous. I think I am gonna go in with this, but I'm gonna grab some glitter glue as well. I'm just gonna take and pop that. Oh my word, honey bunches of oats with strawberries. Oh my God, love you so much. Look at that freaking color. Like, okay, I'm sorry. I'll be wearing this every day if you need me for the next 8 years. I love that color so much. Oh my God, I just wanna take a little bit more just cause I'm really feeling myself. I'm gonna pop it like up in this area, kind of like blend it with my finger. Oh, I love it so much. I wanna take maybe just like a freckle, like a meck of this shade. What is this? This is the shade Provocative. And it's like a little bit of a bronzy moment. Maybe I'll just kind of lightly tap just a teeny little bit of that shade right there. Just a little itty bitty bit right there. Oh yeah, just like just to kind of blend the two together. Oh, yep. I love her. Oh, I love her. You know what? I think just to kind of round everything out, I am going to, I forgot to give myself my little upper wipe right here. Just to kind of, you know, lightly kind of pull that. But anyways, I'm gonna go on the lower lash line here, right underneath of that dark shade that I put there, the shade Spicy. And I'm gonna put a little bit of the shade Arouse, that nice little caramely moment. I'm gonna pop that right underneath, just like I did going through the crease, just to very lightly kind of blend it out. Ooh, and then maybe a little bit of the shade Hypnotic, that light brown, right under that. Oh yes, oh yes. Oh yes, 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 yes. Okay. But I'm gonna take a little bit of the shade Flower Power, which is this one right here, that one I also worked all over the lid. And I'm just gonna use a little bit of that just to kind of very, very lightly put it up in that area. Let's take a little bit here and pop it on the inner corner. All right, so right here we have the first completed eye. Again, nice and neutral, very chill, very everyday, at least for me. And I absolutely love it. Everything blended like a dream. I love, 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 love these neutral brown tones. I think they are gorgeous. And yeah, I had no issues, like literally not one. Everything just looks beautiful, seamless. All right, so let's go into the palette again, going into this eye, and we're gonna do more of the pinky hue, a little bit more depth on this side. And I'm gonna start off with the shade Filthy right here, which is the lighter little pink shade. And I'm taking this on that fluffy brush. I promise we're not gonna use it the whole time, but this is the one that I would use for this action, okay? So you can't hate me. But I'm just gonna take and lightly kind of fluff that all over. This part doesn't have to be like super precise or anything, because it's just a nice little set down color that we're gonna use to blend all the rest into. Ooh, that's actually really pretty. All right, you guys, so we're here. We're just gonna do it. We're really gonna just settle in and sink our teeth into the sultry moment. And I'm gonna take the Naughty Shader, rawr, and this one is more of like a flat kind of packer style brush. And I am going to just kind of really immerse myself into the shade Untamed right here. It's a nice dark purple. Oh, wow. I'm just gonna take and like more so pack the color onto the mobile lid. And then as I am blending out toward the crease, I'm just taking this and kind of flipping it up on its head just to make those edges nice and blended. Ooh, wow, those actually, you know what, for a darker purple, that actually blends really nicely. So I've been sitting here weighing my options for what to do next, and you know, do I want to keep it like bold and bare, you know, what am I really feeling? And I think for this particular eye, I really want to intensify it a little bit more, but also give it a little bit of a lilt. And so I'm going to take the shade Passion, which is the one I was talking about before. You can see it looks a little different in pan, how it has like a kind of like a blue, like a soft blue to pink moment going on. I feel like this shade is absolutely beautiful. I love it. I love the softness that it has. And I want to take some of this and just kind of tap it all over the mobile lid, right on top of that berry tone. Just as a little bit of pizzazzle, but you know, it's nothing like over the top. Just in the center of that, I'm gonna take the shade Shameless, which is kind of like a pinky shimmer. And I'm just gonna pop that one right in the center and lead it up toward the brow bone just a little bit to kind of help open the eye up. Also gonna take those two shades that I used through the crease, the Filthy and Untamed shades. I'm gonna be taking those same shades underneath the eye as well, on the lower lash line. All right, you guys, so with that, I added the same brow bone and the inner eye is on this side from the palette. And let's go ahead and give you our finals. So this is the eye we just finished up. again, the deeper, more sultry looking eye. I just, oh God, I love that color. I think for me, what I love about this side is that it's like sultry and deep and fun and smoky, but it's still not like over the top. It's not unattainable, very easy, super blendable. But even if you're intimidated by that and you're like, I don't know, you can still go with something like this that's a little bit more chill. But I feel like, I don't know, going into this palette, like I'm so impressed with the fact that you really can get like two totally different eye looks. And it kind of really, for me, especially with this one, all boils down to what your definition is when it comes to that sultry, you know, the naughty side of the palette, like what she was going for. Because with everyone, it definitely does change, you know, depending on how you feel when you wear the makeup. And for me, you know, in my day-to-day, I definitely tend to be more of this kind of girl. But I can definitely see, you know, the appeal and the fun and the more flirtatious side of something like this. All right, you guys, I am back. I took a minute. I gave myself like a little half hour break because not only are my little eyeballs like actually quite red on the sides right here, which, wow. Like, oh wow, I can see how red that is even without my glasses. That's terrifying. So my eyes are a little bit red. I had to let my camera cool down because I have been filming, I didn't even realize this, for almost 3 hours doing all of this, the on, the off, the swatches, the whatnot. And I kind of gave everything a second and I am back. And with every time I revisit, I feel like my brows are looking a little bit more busted than the previous. Super fun. So let's go ahead. I also, while I was off of camera, grabbed myself a couple of Smarties, just a couple, while I was, you know, traipsing past the little bag in the hallway. I was like, gotta catch them all. Okay, they're like Pokemon. Gotta just get them all in my mouth because I love Smarties so much. So yeah, grab some of these. Anyways, I'm back. I just finished my Smartie. Let's just wipe off my little mouth. And let's get into the final palette here. Oh, that's beautiful. Hello, this is what she looks like on the inside. And as of this moment, actually, even as we sit here, I have not yet touched, swatched, or watched any reviews on this because going into it, I'm already having like some kind of feeling about it. Like I'm having like my own little opinion. And I didn't want to be like swayed or skewed in any way. Anyways, let's go ahead and do the swatches really quickly here. And don't mind the random sun that I have literally no idea where that's coming from. Excuse me. No, thank you. But in terms of this palette, there are two things I noticed right off the bat that I want to mention. The first one being the texture and the consistency of these. I feel like across the board, shimmers to mattes, duochromes, the whole bit, they all are very, very beautiful, very satisfying, smooth, creamy, like velvety freaking texture when you swatch them. And again, I don't think that that's what it's about necessarily. Everything applies differently to the eye than it does, you know, to the arm and swatch, which is totally understandable. But just in terms of that texture, I am very happy with it. The actual feel of them on my finger, it was very, very rich in opacity. Everything just, whoo, it was like swiping some butter on my arm, okay? It felt very, very nice. So I don't have any issues, again, in terms of texture, consistency. The pigmentation across the board was very even, which is nice. And then the second thing that I noticed with this that I really liked was actually the color story, like swatching it out. So something that I think really needs to be said, especially if you're looking at this, you know, the color story, especially in pan, can be a little bit much. It can be a little, you know, kind of all over the place. And I feel like swatching it out, it actually puts a lot more into perspective. Because for me, at least with palettes like this, I always notice, you know, they have this type of a color or, you know, this kind of a block situation. And I'm always left needing like some sort of a crease color, some sort of a matte shade that I can run through the crease, something to blend the other colors out. You know, you always need those workable shades alongside with the fun ones. And I feel like more often than not, you know, I run into these situations where I'm like, damn, like I really need this bone colored shade, or I need this brown or this light pink, whatever. You just need those additional shades to really work with the beautiful shades. You know, to work with the fun, you also have to have like the sensible part of it that allows you to develop the eye look as a whole. Like about this palette, all of that being said, is that it does come with those more sensible shades, the ones that you can use to work and develop the fun shades or the more intense ones. So this palette, you're not going to need, even though it is on like the weirder looking side, like the color combo of it isn't exactly, you know, normal, quote unquote. I like that with this palette, you can pretty much find everything that you're going to need in here. It can be more of a standalone thing. So you're not going to need like that neutral palette or any other sort of like weird companion or whatever, whatever you want to call it, to pony up with it. You're going to be able to do it on its own and it's going to, you know, be able to pull off a full eye look, which is really nice, especially when you're dealing with like these kinds of colors, these kinds of colors, so on and so forth. All right, so I've been playing around. Obviously, I just laid down my base right here, a little bit more of my Boing Cakeless Concealer. I think we're gonna start off with the shade Diatonic right here. It's just like a nice light peachy shade. And we're gonna kick it off with the 210 Blender from Fenty. And I'm gonna take this shade and just pop it right through the crease. Okay, so two things. Number one, I freaking love this shade. Like, it builds beautifully. It blends out amazingly. I just like that color for some reason. I don't know if it's that, like, it has like a little bit more depth to it. I'm not sure what it is about this color, but I really, really like that. And I love the tone, especially with the other colors I'm going to be playing with. Like, this is a great color. And I think from there, I want to throw on a little bit of the shade Manganese. Yeah, that's the dark purple right here. This palette is $129, you know, just in case you missed that. It did just go really quickly, like quite literally stopped blending and ran off of camera for just a second, because I wanted to check the Sephora site and make sure there wasn't, like, you know, anything else that snuck up on me in terms of this palette. Just something to note that they did lay out on the website, and something that I did touch on, like, aesthetically while it was swatched on my arm. But just to give you guys kind of an idea, it says that these three shades right here that are in the center of the palette, those are all of the multi-chrome shades in this palette, and then surrounding it, so this row and this row respectively, all of those shades are in there to kind of support that multi-chrome shade and kind of build it up, work with it, and make it a little bit more multi-dimensional, easy to work with day to night, that sort of stuff. I'm gonna grab just a little bit of the shade Naga right here, this light purple, and I'm gonna take just a little bit of that and lightly kind of fluff it up through, just so I have a little bit more of like a light purpley kind of look right there. And then from there, I am gonna grab my glitter glue just a little bit here on the back of my hand, and I'm gonna pop that all over this lid right here. I am, of course, gonna go in with the shade Color Flip, which is so beautiful, and I'm gonna take that and just pop it all over the lid. I think for the underside of this, I do want to play around with the green tone a little bit, because the shade right here, this is the shade Scrap, and I really like that. It's like a deep tone green, and I'm going to take that on the Huda. This is the Naughty shader. I just obviously color switched this as well, and I want to take that because I actually think this shade is going to work really nicely with that duochrome. And I want to run it right up next to the lashes. And then also to continue on the lower lash line, because we obviously have that really beautiful green shade, but I want to also add in there a little bit more, like a little bit of something bright. And so I'm going to take the shade Vert right here. It's a nice kind of mustardy, greeny, yellow situation. And I'm going to take that on the same brush and just blend it underneath. Okay, so what is it about this combo that I oddly enjoy? Like, I really love, because I was a little bit on the fence about it at first, like the way that lower lash line, it has just like such a grungy look. I was like, ugh. But now that I have it on and applied, like looking at that up against that purple, there's like something about those two color combos that work so beautifully together. Like, I really, oh my gosh, I really, really like that. All right, so really quick, I'm just going in and adding a little bit of a brow bone inner eye highlight. I know this is not everyone's thing. That's totally fine if you hate it. I literally can't function without it. I feel like my eye looks bizarre. So I'm gonna add one, and I'm doing it out of the Rach Loves Pixie palette right here. But anyways, now that we have this eye done, we're gonna go ahead and get into this side. We're actually gonna dive into the shade Ion first, which is almost like a fluorescent kind of yellow green. And I want to play with this shade because I'm really interested actually in the pigment, like the payoff of it. It is building up nicely. I actually quite like the tone of it. It has a beautiful brightness, and I'm actually really impressed with that, because a lot of times shades that go this more fluorescent kind of route, they don't have this nice of a payoff, and this one actually does, and it's really nice. It blends out like a dream. It does build up. So I'm not mad about it. Like, the color might be light, but the pigmentation is not. And I think that's definitely a positive for me. I am then going to take a little bit of glitter glue and go in with the shade Scarab, which, oh, look at her go, so beautiful. I'm gonna take and just pop that all over, because I really wanna see that shift. Like, I wanna know what she can do. Oh, that's a beautiful, beautiful color. And I'm gonna take that shade Scrap, which is that dark green shade up here in the upper corner, and I am gonna throw that just a little bit on the inner and the outer corner. I think in the shade Manganese, yeah, because that out of all of them is kind of the go-to for the darker purple. So I'm gonna grab this one right here. I'm gonna just take that shade and run it on the lower lashes right here. You know what, just to blend that out a little bit, I'm actually gonna pop up into the Androdite, this one right here, and I'm gonna use that to just very gently blend out the purple. I think it'll add a little brightness to it. And all right, you guys, with that, I just went ahead and obviously finished up the eye look. I added the brow bone and the inner eye, same highlight out of the Rachel Loves Pixie palette. And oh God, this eye look, I don't know what it is about it. I think it's probably like that chartreusey green situation. Oh, I love it so much. I think that there's just something so satisfying about that color and how bright and fluorescent it is. And you know what too? Let's go ahead, let's switch. I think there's something too about the fact that this palette, like these looks are both very, they're very fun, very out there. There really isn't anything that's like overly day-to-day about this in terms of neutrals. But I do feel like both of these eye looks were a very attainable, very easy, very quick. Like it just, again, in terms of the amount of depth and the amount of like fun that they are, I just feel like they were very easy to achieve. But anyways, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead, run off of camera, finish up my face, my hair, all the good things, and I will be back on and we will kind of go over this whole situation in a second. So hang tight and I will be right back. And all right, you guys, with that, through the power and magic of editing, I am back. Intro page is here. Hello. And I wanted to stop back on really quick. Obviously, I hope that you guys liked the eyeshadow looks. I hope they were helpful to you. But I wanted to swing on really quickly and just kind of give a couple of wrap-up thoughts about these palettes. Even though I do think as I moved through them, I kind of said my piece here and there, but there were just a couple of things I wanted to dispense along the way. And I'm actually going to start off with the most recent one, which of course is the Natasha Denona palette. And the thing with me about this palette, I feel like if I'm going to sit here and go the route of, you know, would I buy it, would I not? I'm really struggling with this one because, well, first of all, for me, you know, like in the interest of full disclosure, I actually purchased this palette after the Beautylish gift card event. And so I had, I want to say $60 towards this because I've done other Beautylish videos, which if you missed it, I'll link it up here. I just did one or two of them. I'll link both. But I had gift cards from that sale. And so this one, even though it retails for $129, I paid $69 for it. And for $69, like if this was one of her lower price palettes, like some of the other ones have been recently, I would actually, I don't think I would have too much of an issue with it because I like the aesthetic of it. I like the direction of it. I understand this palette is kind of meant to move a little differently than her other palettes. And I really appreciate that aesthetic. But with me, the problem that I'm having with this and something that I keep going back to is that, first of all, I felt like online when I purchased it, I felt like it looked a lot different than it did when I received it. And I don't know because at this point I haven't watched other reviews, I haven't watched other people, but I don't know if that's something that's just a me thing. I don't know if that's like unique to others or whatever. But for me, that is something I noticed with this palette is that it just does seem a little bit different in person than it was on the internet. I definitely was getting the vibe on the internet that it had more grunge, that it had more of that depth to it. And a lot of these shades do come off a little bit lighter, not a little bit, a lot lighter, and a lot more of like a pastel-y effect, which again, there's nothing wrong with it. It's just not exactly what I thought I was getting in a lot of ways. And so for me, I think with this palette, do I think it's worth $129? I would probably have to say no. No, I think if the aesthetic is for you and you really like it, you like the eye looks, I mean, sure, like the quality of it is fine, but I struggle with saying that yes, it's worth $129 when I've worked with so many other palettes and I feel like with this one, even though I didn't have any issues, I'm still struggling with it being that much. And obviously those are just kind of, you know, kind of my wrap up thoughts on that palette. I'm still not 100% like love it or hate it, but I am having like, you know, conflicting feelings both directions. And honestly, as far as these other two palettes go, I really don't have anything to add. I really, really, really love this palette from Huda. I guess just to briefly recap, I really like it. I have no issues with the colors, the textures, aside from this one freaking shade up here, which I don't like it. It doesn't work for me. I will try it eventually, like on a day where maybe I don't care about my eye look or if it lasts at all. But just on my eyelids, because I know how inhospitable they are, this shade for me just, it doesn't do it. But the rest of the palette overall, I think is absolutely fantastic. I really, really like it. And I really like this the color story here just because I naturally gravitate more towards neutral options. And the thing about Huda, especially with this, like this color story for me, it's not something that's super new. And I just wanted to be, you know, obviously fair, kind of play devil's advocate, because even though I do love it and I really enjoy it, it's definitely just something on the neutral side, something that if you have her other palettes, her other minis, her nude, her remastered, any of those, you probably do have, or even her Desert Dusk, you probably have ones that are similar to this palette. Because the reality is, with a lot of her other palettes, you'd probably see these colors, you know, duplicated in there. And yes, the finishes might change. They might be silkier, different, you know, whatever in that respect. But the reality is, you'd probably be able to achieve very similar looks with other palettes of just hers. Because she does really like to stick in this area when it comes to colors and tones and stuff. But she also does it very well. You know, you can kind of weigh that out. If you like it, you like it, as far as the palette goes. And then just also as a side note, I really like the brushes. They performed really well. And really quick too, I just want to give an extra little nod here to the Juvia's Place palette, because you guys, this palette is freaking good, okay? For $38, I am so, so impressed with this. I feel like everything worked, everything blended. And the reality with this palette, especially as somebody who's, you know, more of a neutral lady, I tend to be that person that I undervalue color. And this is one of those moments for me where I was really able to see a color and a color story and all of these different textures and finishes and just so many things coming together. And truthfully, combining all of these things, even with some duochromes popped in, for the price point of $38, like, you, this is so, so good. Obviously, it's not the most neutral palette in the world. There's quite literally almost nothing neutral about it. So if this is, or if that's what you're looking for, you might want to, you know, go with a different option. But this palette, just in terms of the color and the quality and all the things, I'm really, really glad that I chose to include it in today's video, because I feel like it's something so different, so bold, and so in your face. And I think if I just had to nail it down, there's something about the chaos of this palette more than anything that pulls me in, because looking at it, it just looks like it's so much. And then as you go into it, you realize how beautiful the colors and the textures and everything just flows together. And it's almost like they were able to create something that was beautifully chaotic all at the same time. And also just on top of that, to sprinkle this freaking shade right here, this fake shade, or the shade Money, or that other duochrome, wherever it went, the Abito, or where the hell are you at? Amito, right there. Oh my God, just to sprinkle those three duochromes in there, like, oh, are you kidding me? Especially, again, for $38, you're actually getting three duochromes included. And this is one of those instances where, unlike I was saying with the Denona palette, you didn't have to pay for that inclusion. You didn't have to pay for that trend, because you're getting all of this for $38. There's 30 shades. It's just over a buck a shade. And you're getting, you know, the same kind of concept, just way bigger scale. So again, just kind of, you know, different perspectives, different all across the board. But all right, you guys, I'm going to stop there. This video needs to be somewhat shorter, and I talk a lot, so I'm going to cut myself off. Of course, I want to hear from y'all down in the comments. Okay, so don't leave me hanging. Let me know down there. Do you like the video? Do you like the palettes, the eye looks? Which one was your favorite? Whether it's eye looks or palette, which one is your favorite? And yeah, just give me all of your thoughts and opinions down below. And as I said at the start of the video, you can subscribe, turn on your post notifications, follow me on Instagram, which I would definitely appreciate. And I think that is everything. Thank you guys all so, so much for watching. Please don't forget to have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one.